Hey guys, it's Chris, and welcome back to another Game of Thrones Season 8 video, and this will be my Episode 4 preview video. So if you hadn't already, go check out the Episode 3 review video after I slept on it and processed it for a while, and how we could see a little more information about the Night King and some of the history and lore, prophecy, etc., that a lot of people were upset about that was not included in Episode 3. So anyway, let's jump right into Game of Thrones Season 8 Episode 4 and see what's going down. Alright, so we open up with a shot of Cersei and Euron watching the Golden Company. It looks like they're preparing for war here, so it looks like they're actually making a stand in the Red Keep. So perhaps at this point, they do expect Dany and everybody else to come south. They've probably learned by now that they've won the war. And of course now, since Dany has helped save the North, and the world for that matter, they will feel obligated to help her out. Jon has already pledged his loyalty, and as we know, he is true to his word. Then we have a quick shot of the Unsullied leaving Winterfell and headed back south to King's Landing, I believe, although they may head to Dragonstone first, as we have seen Dragonstone in the previous trailer. Then a quick shot of everyone watching and honoring the dead as they burn them all after the last battle at Winterfell we just witnessed. This is going to be one hell of a bonfire. We hear Dany with a voiceover saying, "We have won the Great War, now we will win the last war," with Missandei and Varys in tow as well. And this is obviously talking about Cersei, because she does want to go take the throne now, and they will now obviously feel obligated to help, as Jon has already sworn. With this little voiceover, we see Dany seeming to be accepted in Winterfell now as she raises a toast in the main hall. So it looks like there will be some conversation next episode where she is probably thanked a lot for coming to help save the North and the world. Although there will be a looming question about what to do with the North after this battle is won or lost. Which brings into question what this third twist is going to be, because now that the Night King is dead, there are no more supernatural elements to deal with. The third twist has to be related to Jon, Dany, Cersei, some political maneuvering, so I have a really bad feeling about this. And it's also interesting here in this shot, we do not see Jon, Sansa, or Tyrion. We see a quick shot of Dany checking on Drogon. Perhaps she's about to leave, or she's just outside checking on him. They did in fact get injured last episode, if you remember. Pretty badly, actually. So we did see Drogon, but we have not seen Rhaegal yet. But we do see him in another shot in this trailer, so we know he is alive. Then we see Arya and Gendry with a little kiss here, showing that it was not just a one-off thing, and they will continue their relationship. So Arya may be very well on her way to becoming a lady. Then we see the mass funeral here, where they burn the dead. It looks like Jon, Dany, Grey Worm, Arya, Tormund, Sam, and Sansa all have torches, so they will likely take turns going out to burn the bodies just to all show some respect. In our next shot, we have Dany looking mad as usual. Maybe back on Dragonstone here, I'm not really sure, but it's likely they will go to Dragonstone first to start the Siege of King's Landing from there. Then we see a shot of Rhaegal, as I mentioned, flying over a ship here. This could be obviously anywhere, going to King's Landing or going to Dragonstone. We see a shot of Euron seemingly proposing to Cersei. This is very odd here. Usually marriages don't work that way in this kind of world, but it looks like Euron is tired of waiting here and he's going to propose to her, although I think they will still screw each other over at some point. We see a shot here of Sansa seemingly watching the dragons leave Winterfell, just like we saw in episode 1 when she saw them arrive. So I suppose Sansa will be staying in Winterfell and not going south, which is the best thing she can do. Then we see a shot of Jon and Davos leaving Winterfell as well. This is going to start this journey south to where they go fight for Dany now to kill Cersei. So this is going to be interesting as far as what's going on with the North after all this ends. Then we see a shot of what's left of the Targaryen fleet, either headed to Dragonstone or King's Landing. And then we see the shot here I was talking about where Dany looks up and smiles, so maybe this is the first time she's seen Rhaegal. After the battle in episode 3, he was obviously wounded and we didn't see him again. So it looks like this may be her looking up and smiling because he's flying to her. She realizes he's okay and still alive at least. Or perhaps maybe this is Jon actually flying him as well. But more than likely, this is going to be the first time she's seen Rhaegal since the battle at Winterfell. And finally, we see Cersei and Euron watching again as we hear Dany say, "We'll rip her out root and stem," reminding us of Varys' junk, or lack thereof. So anyway, that's all we have for the preview of episode 4. So now that we know the Night King is out of the picture, the big bad is now dead, Cersei and Euron will be the remaining villains. So they will certainly focus on the political aspect of Westeros now, as opposed to the supernatural aspect. And it will be very interesting to see how things change when this whole game is over. Anyway guys, let me know what you think in the comments below. And as usual, thank you for all the support, especially to you guys on Patreon. And a huge shout out to my executive Patreon Smokescreen producers. And if you dig what I do here, please give these videos a like, comment, and share. And also be sure to subscribe to get everything. and click that notification bell so you're notified when I drop a new video. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.